بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمد صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وإن تعدوا نعمة الله لا تحصوها، وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: اغتنم خمسا قبل خمس: شبابا قبل حرمك، وصحة قبل سقمك، وفراغ قبل شغلك، وغناء قبل فقرك، حياتي قبل موتك، وكما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. My dear respected brothers and elders and ulama, one of the biggest questions in the world, which we see throughout on the media, be it the Forbes magazine, be it this magazine, Wall Street Journal, we see it all over the place, and there's always a competition to answer this question: who is top of the list? What is the question? Who is the richest person in the world? Who is the richest person in the world? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he explains to us who is the richest person in the world. Who is the richest person? He says, Ghina, al-ghina, ghina al-qalb. That richness is the richness of the heart. It's not material. It's not what you have in your physical life. It's what is in your heart. And what is riches of the heart? Contentment of the heart. Today I would like to speak about two points. I will start on the first point, and if time spares me, then I will finish the other point. The first point is shukr, gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Are we grateful or ungrateful? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, giving us taskeen and giving us happiness, and he says, ما يفعل الله بعذابكم إن شكرتم وآمنتم وكان الله شاكرا عليما. That what will Allah do in punishing you? Will he get anything out of it? إِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ وَآمَنْتُمْ. If you are to be grateful towards him upon his ni'mats and his bounties, and you are to believe and put your faith in him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is shakir. In Urdu we say qadardan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bade qadardan him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very grateful towards his servants. And he's alim, he's all-knowing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another part of the Quran, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you are trying, if you look at the ulama, the ni'mat in this verse is singular, not plural, singular. So Allah says, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ. If you are to count one ni'mat of Allah, لَا تُحْصُوهَا, you will not be able to contemplate one ni'mat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let me break it down for you, make it easy for us to understand. A simple thing of roti on our dastakhan, on our table, at food time. This, it looks very simple, eat it, you finish one roti in no time. How many ni'mats of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this roti? From the time the sun comes out, to the rain, to the farmer who cultivates the land to get the wheat, and then the harvester who comes and cut the wheat, and all the oil and gas that gets used in the harvester, and it goes on from there, is harvest, and it goes through all different mechanical processes, then flour comes into the market, it gets packed, it goes to the supermarket. Supermarket attendants, they put it on the shelf. From there we go and buy it.
we take it out, we still have to add water to it. Ni'mat upon ni'mat. One roti, but so many ni'mat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I will finish. And then to get onto our plate, gas is used. The energy of our wife or whoever is cooking is used. So ni'mat upon ni'mat in one ni'mat. Ek hi ni'mat ke andar kitni ni'mat hai Allah Rabbul Izzat. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, La in shakartum la azidannakum. The Arabic poet says, وَشُكْرُ عَلَىٰ نِعْمَتِهِ يَزِدْكُمْ. That paying gratitude, being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon His ni'mat, upon His bounties, upon His favors, will increase these favors. As Allah says, لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. If you will do shukr, you'll be grateful upon my bounties, I will increase these bounties. And Allah doesn't say that I will just increase. La azidannakum ham zarur bi zarur iskandar ziyadati karim. We will increase it for sure, without doubt. So it's very, very important for us to understand. Sometimes we might be going through different challenges, might have different decrease in this, and in business we might be down, or whatever the situation. But we must always do shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And shukr comes in two ways. Do tariqe se shukr ada karte. One way is by the tongue. Alhamdulillah, Allah tera shukr hai. Tera bahut ihsan hai. Ye tera fadal hai. This is one way, speaking from the tongue. And the other way is doing through our actions. Apne amal ke zariye shukriya ada karna. So upon all those ni'mas Allah has given us, do we use it in the right way? Allah has given us a hand. Allah has given us eyes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us feet to walk. We will not understand the value of our feet unless we look at a person who doesn't have no feet. Once a person was walking, and he didn't have no slippers. So by walking, the bottom of the sole of his feet were getting cut up. So he said, thought to himself, oh Allah, I wish I had some slippers. And someone else passes, and the person didn't have no feet. He's dragging himself on the floor, on the ground. And he said, oh Allah, your shukr. I'm so grateful that you have given me feet that I can walk with. So, through our tongue, always doing shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in hadith, the part of the hadith, وَرْضَ بِمَا قَسَمَ اللَّهُ لَكَ لَكُنْ أَغْنَى النَّاسِ. That be happy, be content, what Allah has written for you. Whatever taqdeer, whatever fate is written for you, whatever you're going to get, be happy with that, and whatever Allah has given you, you will become the most richest person. So this is the richest of the heart, my dear spectators and listeners. So the more we go forward, my dear spectators, in our life, we have ups and downs. Sometimes we have less, sometimes we have more. How the saying says, if you have a roof above your head, you're better than millions. Because there are millions in the world who don't have no roof above their head. They don't have no clothes to save them from the cold weather and the snow. Just the other day we saw one of the charities, I think it was the Al-Imdad Foundation in Jordan, who went to give out some charity and some donations towards the Syrian refugees in Jordan. There's a girl who's walking with slippers in snow. And they're living in tents. So looking at this, my dear spectators and listeners, we are much better off. So whatever Allah has given us, be it little or be it more, we always be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because upon this gratitude that we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will continue. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will continue blessing us. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us a dua, a very simple dua. But this dua has very much meaning. We should continuously, as Mu'afaz Rahman Sahib, Dawam Al Khatum from South Africa, he always in his bayanat will always encourage the public and everyone to read this dua. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the dua, he supplicates to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What does he say? Allahumma inni as'aluka ar-radha ba'da al-qadha. Allahumma inni as'aluka ar-radha ba'da al-qadha. O Allah, we seek from you, we supplicate towards you, we ask from you, ar-radha ba'da al-qadha, that give us happiness, pleasure, contentment upon whatever fasla, whatever decision you do for us. Be it towards the right, be it towards the left. Be it up and be it down. Ar-radha ba'da al-qadha. And we be happy with it. Once, I think it was one of the mashayikhin, I think it was Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullahi alayhi, I might be wrong. He was sitting down. And while he was sitting, as we know, he was a very big business person. Even though he was a big imam, he was a very big business person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given him a big business. And he had a lot of wealth Allah had given him from his khazana, from his treasures. So he was sitting down with his servants and his murids and his students. And somebody came to him and said to him in his ear something. And then he put his head down and he picked up his head and said, Alhamdulillah. After a little while, the same person comes again and said to him again something. He put his head down and said, Alhamdulillah. So his students and his murideen and the persons around him asked him, we don't understand the situation. So he explained. He said, the person that came first, he said to me that the ship which had your cargo on it has sunk. So I put my head down and I checked my heart. Am I happy with this fasla and decision of Allah, or am I not happy? And I realized my heart is content. So I said, Alhamdulillah. All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, after that, the person that came again, he told me that, Alhamdulillah, that the ship was saved and your cargo is safe. So I put my head down again and checked my heart. Is there any change? And I realized it's nothing. I am still happy with the hukum and the decision of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I said, Alhamdulillah. So this is contentment of the heart, being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and showing our gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In that way, my dear speakers and this, these ni'mas that we see today, which Allah has given us, will increase. But the other part, Allah says in the same ayat, وَلَئِن كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. There's always two parts of the story. وَلَئِن كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. If you are ungrateful, Allah save us. If you are ungrateful, then Allah says, my adab, my punishment, the repercussions will be severe. See to ourselves, my dear speculars and this. In the world, we have seen people, how my Ustad has Shabbat, Mr. Musayyadi Shah, rahmatullah alayhi, may Allah fill his noor, his qabr with noor. He used to always say, pehle laak pati tha, road pati ban gaya. Pehle laak pati tha, road pati ban gaya. He was such a rich person. He had millions and billions or whatever Allah had given him. Now he's a beggar. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it doesn't take time to change anything in the world. When Allah wants to take away something, He will take it away. When Allah wants to give, He will give. Allah is not muhtaj of anyone in making any kind of decision. When He wants to give respect, He will give respect. When He wants to disgrace someone, He will disgrace them. قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ تُؤْتِي الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتَنْزِعُ الْمُلْكَ مِمَّنْ تَشَاءُ وَتُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتُذِلُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرُ إِنَّكَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say, O Allah, قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ, you are the King of Kings, you're the greatest of all. تُؤْتِي الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءُ, You give sovereignty, you give rulership to who you want. وَتَنْزِعُ الْمُلْكَ مِمَّنْ تَشَاءُ, you take away from who you want. وَتُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ, you give respect to who you wish. وَتُذِلُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ, you disgrace who you wish. So everything is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we will go this way, we will get increase in ni'mat. If we go this way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can take away things in this world, my dear smokers. So shukr upon ni'mat. Jitna shukr ada karenge, itni ni'mat mein ziyadati hogi. Agar, na'udhu billah, Allah hamein bachaye. Agar na shukri hui, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ni'mat ko chheenne mein kisi ka muhtaj nahi. Chheen bhi sakte hai, de bhi sakte. Coming on to the second point, since we're coming close to Ramadan, mashallah, hopefully one of the ulama will speak about zakat, the obligatory zakat and the masail. I just want to touch about nafil sadaqah. Sadaqah can come in different ways. Simple thing, imatatul adha anit tariq, sadaqah. To remove something that will be harmful from the walkway, driveway, anyway, is sadaqah, is a charity. Kalimatul tayyib, sadaqah. To say something good is sadaqah, is charity. So sadaqah is not only monetary. It can be done through our akhlaq and our characteristics, and it can be done monetary. Be it financially, be it physically, socially, in different ways. Sadaqah is a very broad word. And be it Allah has given us a lot, give sadaqah. Even Allah subhanahu has given a little bit, give sadaqah. How much way we can? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked through the Sahaba, he instructed Bilal radiallahu anhu. He says, Ya Bilal, anfiq, O Bilal, spend. وَلَا تَخْشَ عِنْدِ الْعَرْشِ إِقْلَالًا, and don't fear that Allah will give you less. Allah will always give you more. Allah will look after you. Allah will look after you. The more you will give, the more Allah will give you. If you don't get in this world, Allah will give you in the akhirat. Coming back to the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that when a person يقول العبد مالي ومالي وإن ماله من ماله ثلاث, that a person says my wealth, my wealth, my wealth, really and truly only three types of his wealth are his. Besides that, nothing belongs to him. ما أكل فأفنى, whatever he ate and he done away with. وما لبس فأبلى, whatever he wore and became old. وَمَا تَصَدَّقَ فَأَقْتَنَا, and whatever he gave in sadaqah and he put in the bank of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَا عِنْدَكُمْ يَنْفَدُ وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ بَاقٍ, what you have today is going to finish. كُلُّ مِنْ عَلَيْهَا فَانٍ, whatever you have today is going to finish. And whatever Allah has him in his treasures is going to stay forever and ever. So, وَمَا تَصَدَّقَ فَأَقْتَنَا, whatever we give in sadaqah, that will go in the bank of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever goes in the bank of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stays safe. Nobody will rob it. وَمَا سِوَى ذَلِكَ ذَاهِبٌ وَتَارِكُهُ لِلنَّاسِ. Rasulullah s.a.w. says, whatever besides that out of your wealth is not yours, when you leave this world, it will go to your inheritance. So this is a story today, my dear brothers and sisters. The more we will give, the more Allah will give us. Be a little bit, be it a lot. Whatever we can give. Be it somebody who is stopped on the road, who has a flat tire. Be it Muslim, non-Muslim. we know him or we don't know him. If we have time, we can help him, help him. This is sadaqah. Be it our neighbor, be it anyone, my dear speaker, brothers. And the best sadaqah, my dear speaker, brothers, the best charity is towards our family. The best charity is towards our family. Be it our children, be it our extended family, be it anyone that we know, be it our neighbors, be it our community people. You see someone who's in need of something, be it money or he needs the help of something, we help him in whatever way we can. If Allah has given us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has opened doors for us, we help him in a good way. قَوْلٌ مَعْرُوفٌ وَمَغْفِرَةٌ خَيْرٌ مِّنْ صَدَقَةٍ يَتْبَعُهَا أَذَى. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُبْطِلُوا صَدَقَاتِكُمْ بِالْمَنِّ وَالْأَذَى. And whatever we give, my dear speaker, brothers and sisters, we give it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We give it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't give it for any fame, or we don't portray that, oh, I have this guy and I have this guy and I have this person and I have that person. No, my dear speaker, brothers. Who did we do it for? For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember the story of Ali radiallahu anhu and Hazrat Fatima radiallahu anha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, their story was so significant in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought the ayat of the Quran down for them. Both of their sons, Hassan and Hussein radiallahu anhum ajma'in, were sick. They had made mannat, they made a promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if both of them become well, we will keep 3 days of fast. We'll keep 3 days of fast. He says, Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the two children good health and they kept the 3 fasts. The first day, when they kept their fast, at time of iftar, somebody comes to their doorstep asking for charity. Whatever they had in the dustakhan, they give it to the person. And then the second day, the same thing. Third day, the same thing. And then, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he explains about the ikhlas, he says, إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا. We fed these people, even though we were in need, we still fed them. But who did we do it for? إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ. We fed them for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا نريد منكم جزاء ولا شكورا. Neither we na shukriya chahiye na koi badla chahiye. Neither we do we want any kind of thanks from anyone, or neither we want any kind anything in lieu for that. We've done it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So then, my dear speakers, and simple way, my dear speakers, our life is very short. If not today, tomorrow. We see in front of us, young, old have left the world. People are 35 and people are 40. People are 45 and people are 55. The time has, you know, when we used to hear somebody at 85 and 90 going from the world, very few. أعمار أمتي ما بين 60 وسبعين إلى 70 أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم says that the أعمار, the ages of my ummah is between 60 and 70. Whatever after that is bonus. So this is the ummah of Rasulullah SAW, the last ummah of Rasulullah to come in the world. We've come a very short time. So we have to value our time through being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, doing as much charity as possible. Of course, our obligatory zakat is there. Ramadan is coming up. Normally, most of the brothers calculate from Ramadan to Ramadan. But besides that, whatever sadaqah we can give out, in whatever way, be it helping someone, be it helping someone physically, monetarily, financially, whatever way, we can help each other. Be your brother's keeper. وَاللَّهُ فِي عَوْنِ الْعَبْدِ مَا كَانَ الْعَبْدُ فِي عَوْنِ أَخِيهِ. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم says, وَاللَّهُ فِي عَوْنِ الْعَبْدِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with that person and is in help of that person who helps his brother. So once we help another person, Allah will help us. Allah جب ہم دوسری کی مدد کریں گے اللہ ہمارا مدد کرے. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the understanding. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this month of Ramadan come upon us ma siha wa salama. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us sihat, salamat, peace, and keep reaches towards Ramadan and give us the tawfiq to do do such amal that he become happy with us, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our reaching to Ramadan. Allahumma baliqna fi Rajab wa Sha'ban wa baliqna Ramadan. Allah give us barakat in Rajab and Sha'ban. Sha'ban has started today. Yesterday was the first night of Sha'ban. So we only have less than 30 days to Ramadan. Less than either 29 or 28 days. We are in the first of Sha'ban already. So Ramadan is around the corner. Time to prepare ourselves, just like all the business people, they prepare themselves for Christmas in advance. 2-3 months in advance, they do all the ordering. They make sure their curtains and their bed sheets and everything is there. Likewise, my dear brothers, and this is the time we have to build ourselves, our connection with our Rabb, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give me first of all, and give all us the tawfiq to be grateful servants. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to give out sadaqah and make it a means of our connection being closer to Him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take us to Ramadan and make our Ramadan a very good one. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.